You're the conductor. Gay train is what happens at an Asking Alexandria concert. All hail, rap motherfuckers, get back, snort rails. Kick back with a six pack, hell, he gon' do what he want, leave another zip pound. A podcast level's far beyond that. This ain't no bullshit, it's marsh pits and all that. Real talk with a steel got tasty. Rat stiff, spill jizz on your faces. Gone ape shit, blaze it and take it in. Rat talks with crack rocks and gin. Metalheads unite with a grin. Goddamn master man, that's real shit now. So open up your mind to smoke a bowl. A bunch of potheads getting stoned, you know how it go. It's the new show on the block, 100% uncut rock top.
Yeah, I love listening to that theme song, dude. It gets me fucking pumped. It gets me ready. It gets me going for a new episode of Rat Talk, ladies and gentlemen. I am your host, Matt the Rat. And with me this week is co-host Ryan D.
Yo.
And our guest today is welcome back, Steve Rogers.
Hey, how's it going? You almost forgot again.
I know. No, actually, I didn't hesitate on saying it this time. Now I fucking know your name.
You should turn him Roger. Up a little bit. He's always a little bit further away from
a
the
little,
mic.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't condone that song bringing up the drug behavior. I don't condone that.
It is a little much, but you know what? That's what we talk about here, dude. We get drug at, well, actually, Gabriel's probably the only drug addict that's been here, and he's been clean for quite a while now.
Crack rocks and jizz on your face. That's what the show's about.
It's crack.
Yeah, it's a party.
He says gin.
Oh, he said gin?
Yeah, but not jizz.
I hear jizz every time.
No, it's
jizz on your face, yeah.
Crack rocks and gin.
Oh,
I guess it. Like, jizz.
Yeah, jizz on your face.
That's his Fred Durst side coming out.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Hey, anyway.
Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, we're just here having fun today. We got a couple topics.
Tuckets,
we're going to have a couple topics going on later on. But actually, me and Ryan D just got back from an awesome trip in Santa Rosa we want to elaborate everybody on.
Yes.
It was fucking amazing.
It was awesome.
It was the way Vicky Fingers pronounces it. Beercation.
Beercation.
It was a beercation. We just went, got fucked up all weekend.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it was great. Me and Amanda tagged along this time because it was her birthday just the day before we left. So I wanted to take her out, do something fun. So that's why we tagged along. But you guys have done it for, that was your third
this
year?
This was my third year. Vicky's been doing it for, I think, five or four or something.
Have you ever been up north to Santa Rosa?
No, I've never been up there. The first up north I've been is Fresno.
Really?
Really?
You never even been to San Francisco?
No, never been to San Francisco. I've been like all across the Midwest and the East Coast, but.
Well, I'm one to talk. I haven't gone very far either.
Furthest
I went, actually, the furthest north I've been is Washington, I guess, like borderline Canada.
See? Yeah.
There you go.
But I flew, and that was my first time on a plane. And that was just a year ago.
Yeah, that doesn't really matter. Like, people fly. Like, I'd rather fly to San Francisco now. Like, it's a fucking long ass drive.
Yeah.
Like, I would rather just fly if I had the
hour-long flight.
I don't mind the drive. It's just the if you have a reliable car. Like, I was a nervous wreck the whole way because I thought a tire would blow out or my engine would explode.
Which almost did.
Didn't your tire almost blow out?
Almost did happen. Yeah.
Almost happened.
We didn't talk about that on Humpcast yesterday, but yeah, man. Luckily, we noticed that there was
an air bubble
bubble right on the side of my
big
front
giant
tire.
Fucking boil.
And I like, and it's funny because that whole time I was thinking like, that's my old tire, just that one tire up front. It was starting to bald. I noticed that. And I was like, maybe I should. And I was like, no, I think it'll make it. And
and then sure enough, we run over a puddle and it steams.
It's steamed
like,
up.
Steam
yeah.
Flies out of it.
Yeah. Luckily, there was a tire shop right across the street and we got a used tire for $45.
Yeah, Gutierrez tires, man. Shout out.
It was, you know,
beep, 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 beep.
And that was the thing about this trip, too, man. It was like I kept getting stressed out and then things kept working out. Like I was stressed the whole time, the whole drive, thinking some shit was going to happen to my car.
Yeah.
And then just the tire. And I was like, if we drive on this tire, it's going to fucking blow up. So
we
got to switch it.
And you scored on the tire. It was only $45.
I was like, tires are fucking expensive and who knows how much they are out here. Yeah. You know? And it's like, and we need it. So,
yeah.
You know, the first he quoted me for $95, and then he found a used one for $45. So,
and it's a pretty good condition too.
Yeah, it was. So,
Now I have a good front tire.
A better one, at least.
Yeah.
One that's not going to fucking boil up and explode.
Well, that's the one I got a flat on. I had a nail in it. And
was it just patched up?
I patched it up. In San Diego, actually, for Comic-Con, I got a nail in it.
Oh, I was going to say, it wasn't when we went.
And then it went completely flat, and I had to put the spare on it, and I just went and got a new tire, because I don't trust used tires in El Monte anymore. Because I got you some used tires for my last car, and like it looked like they glued tread to it. Because the thing just started deteriorating after I bought them for like $30 each, you know?
Yeah.
So now I just buy new tires.
Yeah.
But when we were out there, I was like, you know, fuck it, used tire. We gotta get going, and I'm not gonna spend $100 out here.
I mean, it didn't look like it was put together with hot glue or anything.
No, it's fine. But that's why. And then later, I bought the other three. So the other three are fine because they were starting to go out. But I still had an older one that I got like 2 years prior.
And it just so happens that was the one.
That was the one. Yeah,
that was the one that would have doomed us if we fucking drove any further.
Yeah.
And dude, we were in the middle of like cow country. Like it was
the spot. I do this place with Jingles sometimes. It's in a Paso Robles area, and it's like wine country. Sort of, but with less black people.
Well, yeah,
because they're not allowed there. I mean, it's what
one of those.
It's what it seems like.
One
yeah,
of those pastor towns. Yeah, I don't stop. Yeah, I'm on E. I'll make it to the next city.
The way to get to that venue is you get off that freeway and then just go left and keep driving, and that's where you'll eventually hit it.
It's like the titty twister in From Dusk Till Dawn.
Yes,
turn on one random road and you'll see it eventually.
It was so fucking weird, and I've done it twice, and it's just nothing but
really. That was right there off of where we got
off.
That's
where we were, yeah. So it was an hour west of there.
Oh, shit.
But yeah, and like that place, you hit that road and it's fucking nothing. Just nothing. Like not even a gas station. Like that's the last place you'll go until you hit that town.
Goddamn.
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty fucked up.
But that's how I was like, I remember here. We stopped at this gas station before.
I mean, but as you go along, though, on the main highway up towards San Francisco, Santa Rosa, where we were heading.
It's just all farmland.
Yeah, it's like Teletubbies. Like,
yeah, it's beautiful. Well, especially because of all the rain we've been getting.
Oh no, everything is green now.
Yeah, so
great.
It was just so much nicer actually this time around. I mean, sometimes we go up there, it's all brown.
Yeah,
it's
shitty.
A little better to look at. The sky was.
I mean, the one thing that was bringing me down was all the fucking "Vote to Make America Great Again" signs.
Yep, plenty of those. Yeah.
You got to know whenever you get out of the city, you get out of the suburbs, out of civilization. That's
dude,
you're
but this
run
person
into.
Had like giant. At least 5 billboards within a 30-mile radius.
Yeah.
It was subliminal, man. Like, you saw it, and you're like, huh? And then you saw it again, and you're like, what the fuck?
Yeah,
didn't
they're
I just
all
see
over
that?
The place out there.
Surprised you guys didn't see any Confederate flags.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, on that road that I was talking about, going to that place, you'll see plenty.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Once you're in the sticks.
Dude, you'll see plenty out there.
Yeah. That's fucking horrible.
Which is weird, because even some of, like... what you realize up, you know, in like mid California, you start noticing that some of the even the Hispanics up there, you know, they hang out, they've moved up there and they've been there for a couple generations, that they have nothing but racist white friends.
Yeah.
And those are also the Trump supporters, like the guys who also think that, like, you know, black people and Mexicans are ruining the country. And they're also Mexican. It's just, it's fucking weird, dude. It's just, it's a huge culture shock passing through places like that.
Man, well, we finally get the fuck out of Hicktown, and we get into the Bay Area, and that was my first time ever being in San Francisco, being that far north either. Like, that's the farthest I've gone also, but I mean, so worth it. It's so nice.
So nice. I know. You know,
you can see the Golden Gate Bridge.
You've never been to San Francisco, but I don't even like. I mean, go once. Then that's it. It's not that cool. It's not. It's really not that cool. Like, people, you know, who talk about it, like, I'm sure if you have, like, business out there or something, sure, it's. I mean, it's a nice city, but it's no different than L.A., you know? It's just, it's the same shit. There's homeless people, tweakers. And nice. The only difference is it's closer to the ocean and it's all combined. It's real crammed together, so.
And Alcatraz, dude. I would love to go to Alcatraz, man.
Why?
Because.
I went.
I've never.
I went. It was cool.
Really? I've never, like, had a... thing. Like, I want to go visit an abandoned prison.
It's interesting, man.
It's interesting.
Even like Alcatraz, yeah. I don't know.
It's, I mean, it's, it was dope. I had, I mean, it's informative.
I mean, also, if you know, like, any history of Alcatraz, like, some pretty crazy shit happened
some
there.
Some nutty right? stuff, man. I don't yeah. know. But, like, that's just, I have kind of a, I mean, well, we both have this interest in, like, just weird, creepy stuff.
Yeah.
So, like, I would, I'd be that guy that would want to, like, visit the Amityville house if I was ever
see,
out
see, I would
like,
I would go there.
Yeah, yeah, like, definitely.
Like, there was a place, like, when I was living in Kansas for those 2 years, there was a place called, like, Stoll, Kansas, mm-hmm. and they had this whole weird thing, like, the church that was built there that ended up, like, burning down was, like, a gate to hell, like, one of the seven gates
sweet.
To hell.
Oh, crazy.
And, yeah, it was creepy. We went there, but just, Alcatraz just seems like, all right, it's a bad prison.
It's cool, man. I gotta say, I mean, you take just the whole idea of these, you know, radical prisoners put on a fucking rock in the middle of the bay, and then, like, how torturous it must be to hear the city from where they are.
Yeah.
And that's how kind
of... All the noises and everything.
Yeah, we did this audio tour thing where you put headphones in and you hear from, like, actual guards and prisoners who were there and stuff, and they kind of... You walk through and you play, like, a track on the thing, and it...
Oh, that's
and
fucking nuts.
And it's wherever you are, it'll tell you, and it'll tell you, look down, there's, like, you know, bullet holes on the floor or something like that.
Yeah.
And they really break down this one giant riot that happened and how they got onto the roof and were dropping grenades.
Oh, fuck.
And that's how they had
the inmates were?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. So is that like, is that, that'll explain
not,
like
no,
some
not
of
the,
the...
Not the inmates, I'm sorry. The
guards?
The guards and like the SWAT team had to come across and like...
Oh, fuck.
Yeah. Yeah. It's nuts, man. Especially like being there and then being, you know, you can kind of see what they got to see, which is shitty, because if you're in the prison yard, you see this giant city like right across the fucking bay.
And yeah, you're just
and
like,
you're like,
fuck.
I'm stuck. Like that's torturous, man.
I think that would be more comforting, at least nah. knowing like I'm out there. Like I'm gonna
so.
Get out. Like it's there. Freedom's there. Like there's an end to this. But if I'm in somewhere like they have prisons down, like out in the desert in the middle of nowhere, where you look outside and it's just fucking nothing, like that would drive me more crazy than just being somewhere locked up and seeing a city, you know?
I don't know.
I guess it just depends on who
I
you
guess,
are. Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Well, some of those things, like I was saying, the audio thing, some of them would be like, yeah, we would hear the city going off and we would have dreams about dancing and all this stuff. It was like,
oh,
like,
man.
How sad is that?
Whatever you got to do.
Then you wake up
sane.
In a fucking goddamn yeah. prison cell.
Yeah, it was nuts, man. It's super creepy too, certain spots, and just kind of like inhumane in certain areas.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
They put you in a... If you volunteer, they'll put you in solitary for 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And it's literally just a sealed black, pitch black room with a bucket. That's it.
Yeah.
Nothing.
Nothing
it's
else.
Crazy.
Yeah.
So in the morning, like if you had to shit or whatever, then in the morning they would open up the door and spray you with a hose. And that's...
that's how you got clean.
That's how they cleaned you up before you came out of the fucking solitary.
Ah, man, it's so menacing, dude.
Pitch black room, like you can't see literally nothing. Like,
yeah,
and they put
I
you in
totally,
there.
I would totally do it. I mean, 5 minutes is that's a long
some
time.
Some people
dude.
Were like crying when they came out, and they're like, "Yeah, imagine being there for 2 days." Like you, yeah. we only put you in there for 5 minutes.
Yeah,
you
that's
can't
be
hear anything.
Crazy.
Like, nothing.
Oh man, I want to go do that.
It's interesting. I just think it's interesting. I don't know. I just
yeah.
like you know. I'm kind of a history buff though too.
Yeah. Yeah. Didn't John Dillinger escape from Alcatraz?
Yeah, they talk about that. Three guys. Yeah.
Wait,
three.
Didn't John Dillinger get killed?
No.
Not in Alcatraz.
No, isn't he the bank robber?
Wait, he got killed?
Yeah.
Well, actually, no, he didn't escape. There was three dudes that did. There were
yeah, there's. I've heard about that. The three guys that escaped and
yeah.
never found him.
I don't
them.
Think John Dillinger... He tried to escape.
From Alcatraz?
Yeah.
Oh.
I don't know. Let's Google it. We got computers.
I know, right? Look it up. History.
Because didn't they do a movie with Johnny Depp about John Dillinger?
John Dillinger,
yeah.
Yeah,
John Dillinger eventually gets shot outside of a movie theater, I think it was.
Yeah.
At least that was in the movie. But yeah, he's done prison sentences. Like, he's been in prison
oh,
before.
Oh, yeah,
since
he escaped from jail twice.
Mm-hmm. He escaped a couple times, yeah. And then I know he was, I don't know. Oh, I got the wiki. I got the wiki here. Talk, guys.
Was he at Alcatraz?
I'm looking it
is
up.
That,
yeah, I don't
that,
think he was
I
at Alcatraz.
I don't think he
talking
was,
about
but
like
he did
Chicago
escape.
And Indiana.
Oh, okay.
Now, the other guys, they were three brothers or something like that. And they,
oh, crazy.
Yeah, they got out.
And they got out.
They never found
and
them.
And they never found them.
I've heard like they think like maybe they got eaten by the sharks or something.
Or
they
drowned.
But yeah, they never found them.
Crazy.
Yeah, they never found their bodies in the bay or nothing.
In the bay or anything? What if they actually escaped?
It's possible.
Yeah.
Damn. Because, I mean, how? Because I was looking at that, I mean, being there.
Isn't that what The Rock is about, the movie?
No.
Which one's that one about?
I mean, The Rock is a good movie. It was just one of Michael Bay's.
I don't know.
These are movies with Sean Connery and Nick Cage?
No, The Rock I thought had... No, that's... I'm sorry. I'm thinking of Escape Alcatraz with fucking Clint Eastwood.
Oh.
Which is obviously what that one's about.
Yeah. Yeah, you're talking about The Rock from the 90s.
Yeah, that's
with Sean Connery.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Dwayne Johnson?
Yeah. No, that's what that movie's about with Clint Eastwood.
Well, either way, it's fucking trippy to see it, dude. Like, to see that rock right there. I mean, yeah, basically what it is, just a giant rock that they threw this prison on.
Well, they shut it down after those guys escaped.
Did they?
Yeah. So they still have the cell that they chiseled open. So you can kind of see how they left.
That's crazy. And how did they leave?
They explain it. They got into, in between the walls is all the pipes. But there was a crawl space. So they had one of the guys had a spoon, and he just like started carving away a hole behind the sink, but painted a thing that looked like the wall. So every time guards would come by, he'd just put it back.
Oh shit!
He made this tiny hole,
Andy Dufresne style.
So he made this tiny hole, and I think the three of them did it, and they lost like 30 pounds each, so they could fit through it. So they all starved themselves for like a couple weeks, and then squeezed through this thing and left dummies, made paper mache dummies, and did the old fucking
switcheroo,
and like, shit you only see in the movies. So yeah, they made these paper mache dummies and whatever they made the hair out. And I think they even have I don't know if they're the original ones, or maybe some replicas or whatever.
Man,
but they have
fucking.
And they
crazy.
Show you how they did it. They just crumbled up some sheets and then put the fucking head on the thing. So anytime the guard would come by, so they didn't know they were gone until the next day.
Wow. Fuck yeah, they probably made it then. They probably. I mean,
I don't know. Being malnourished and then swimming across the bay. That might.
Yeah.
Depends.
I mean, that's the thing.
It's possible. Yeah.
I think it's less
because you can if you know how to float. You know, you can save your energy.
Yeah.
You know, you just sit there in the bay and let the current kind of fucking take you because it's going to eventually take you somewhere.
And they had the time too by them.
Yeah, with
having
them doing
the dummies.
It at night.
Yeah.
And you got to think maybe a good 8 hours.
Well, some people say that when they did it, it was around the time where the temperatures in the water were unbearable, so they could have just froze to death.
Oh yeah, probably.
And then the current probably just took them out.
Yeah,
they're probably still floating out there somewhere.
Yeah, so that's what some people have said.
Oh.
But
yeah, if it was that time, then
I like to think they got away.
I like to think they got away too. Fuck the system, man. Well, we kind of derailed from our whole beercation and everything, but the whole reason why we went on this beercation was to go try Pliny the Younger. If you don't know who Pliny is a philosopher back in the day. I'm not going to go too much into detail who exactly it was, but they made a brew. Russian River Brewing Company made a double IPA and called it Pliny the Elder. And Pliny the Younger only comes out once a year for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Once a year for 2 weeks, and it's like one of those very limited, you have to get a wristband, and you're only allowed three at a time.
Every time they do it, it's always around the San Francisco Beer Week. And that's their release for the competition or for the beer week. That's how it started, was that they did the special brew for San Francisco Beer Week, and it became this huge sensation because, I mean, even down here, the Pliny the Elder is a hot commodity down in L.A.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. I know a lot of people who love Pliny.
Yeah, whenever they do a tap takeover, good luck getting to the bar.
Well, you know, interesting enough, in Sierra Madre, the Lucky Baldwin there, they'll have it on tap for like a month or like, you know, even like a season. Yeah, and like it's like a common thing. Like that place is a craft beer place, and they specialize, you know, and they'll even sometimes they'll even do a younger event.
What?
I did not know that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow.
Well, that's they do it in the one in Pasadena. But I just don't. Yeah, that thing's probably not even gonna fucking work.
Lighter.
Oh well, if you could figure that one out too, that one sucks too. We need better bottle openers in here. I have one in my car that I just got from Lagunitas.
Hold on, wait.
There you go. Angel City. Yep. Oh, you got it.
Coming through.
Why is this so hard?
I don't know. It was just annoying me yesterday. Could have been just because I was too drunk.
Seemed pretty easy.
But so Pliny the Younger is their special brew that they only come out very once in a while.
Yep.
Like Ryan said, Lucky Baldwin's carries it for a little bit.
Yeah, this place in Alhambra does too. Like, there's a lot of places that tap it for like, they'll do it for like a day or two or something like that.
And it's like, it goes out, dude. Like,
yeah,
it's one of those.
But the funny thing is, down here, to, like when you go down to those events down here, they'll serve you a pint. You know, up there, you can't. You're only allowed the three of them.
Or for the younger.
Yeah, and it's a 10-ounce glass.
Yeah,
you're only allowed three 10-ounce glasses, and it's, I think it's like $4 each. Yeah. But
well, I mean, because you, I know you told me like when they do this up there, you have a 3-hour limit.
Yeah.
Well, probably someone fucked it up for everybody else. Probably pounded a bunch in that 3-hour limit.
No, no, sure. I mean, that's why they have such tight security. We saw them kick this couple out that were fucking wasted. They were like running into each other and just like they were trying to talk to each other, but they just couldn't even stand up straight. Yeah, and it was like. And
what the fuck? I'm driving.
Yeah, it's funny.
Yeah.
But anyway, yeah, it gets ridiculous though how much of an event it is. Like, I think realistically they could probably do it for another 2 weeks and
still have the same result.
But it's like they do the 2-week thing and they don't let that many people in at once. Which is nice when you're actually in there because then it's not so packed. Like, you can actually get a table and sit down and like,
yeah,
it's cool once you finally fucking get in, but, kind of sucks when you're in line because, some people wait in line like eight fucking hours.
Yeah. Wait in line 8 hours to get a taste of Pliny the Younger.
That's ridiculous.
That's way ridiculous in my opinion.
People actually camp.
Yep. Right up front.
Yeah. They'll camp right up front.
It's just, when Vicky told me about it too, because she's the one who told me about this whole thing, and I'm like, that sounds ridiculous. And I was like, yeah, I'm down to go. Like, we'll hit some breweries and shit, blah, blah, blah.
And when I'm not going to wait.
Well, no, and she was telling me, she's like, we have to get there and like get in line because there's so many fucking people that go and get in line, and we're going to wait hours. And I was like, no one's going to wait in line for beer.
For 3 beers.
Yeah. And we get there. I'm like, what? Oh my God. Fuck.
Sometimes the line will go around the block.
All the way around the block, yeah.
Yeah,
That's all the time. That's every time I've been there. But, last year we figured out that if you go at a specific time, the line
is not that bad.
Yeah. So if you go in the evening, everybody decides to go in the morning. Everybody goes in the morning, waits all fucking day, and that's the worst time to go. So if you go at, like, 6-7 o'clock when everybody's already had theirs, gotten loaded, gotten in, got left, you know.
No line.
There's line, but it's like an hour.
Yeah.
Oh, hour and a half. That's not bad.
So here's what I say about this beer. It's great. It's amazing. It's not worth more than 2 hours.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. 3 hours pushing it if it's your first time.
Sure. We waited 3.5 the first time.
Yeah. 3 hours is pushing it, but 2 hours,
yeah. Yeah.
I didn't even have all three of mine. I had one because we've been drinking all day, and I didn't.
Yeah.
Eat right. Basically, I had a giant fucking potato all day.
That's all you had, huh? Just a fucking potato and
some pieces of chicken and slice of pizza
and beer
and beer.
Yeah, I had like a kale salad with my gigantic goat burger.
Well, that's good. You prepared. Eat healthy.
Well, I had it came with my burger, so like. Lagunitas knows, man. Like, yeah, I ordered a goat burger.
Yeah.
I ordered a lamb burger, and they gave me the... And it's like a fucking half-pound burger. A half-pound burger.
Mm-hmm.
And then they came with a kale salad.
It's like, you're about to wreck your body.
Yeah.
Please get something good
so
in
I
there.
Ate the kale.
Here's some protein and some fucking salad.
Some greens, yeah, to get you moving. Which is why when we finally got to Pliny to Russian River, I ordered just like a veggie platter and
all this stuff.
We ate like shit, man. Greens. But I did my best to like try and keep some greens in me.
Yeah. Yeah, that definitely helped me out because I felt like shit. I ate like shit. I was drinking shit, and so I just felt like shit.
So what did you think of the beer, though?
Amazing! Oh, that beer was so fucking good. Like you described it, like you taste it. It tastes like an IPA. You know, you got a little bit of hops in it. It's real sweet, but it's smooth.
Mm-hmm.
It's very smooth going down, and there's no aftertaste, like none.
Yeah, like normally there's that IPA aftertaste, like I was saying yesterday.
Yeah.
And then like you get that, it just doesn't exist.
No, yeah.
It's just like it's not there.
It's like you took a sip of like juice or something.
Yeah. Yep. And then you feel it burn a little bit like a wine. Because it's 10.8 I think it's like 10.2.
No, I've never had the younger, but I've had, you know, the Blind Pig, right. And I've had, you know, just Pliny the Elder
It's just the Elder on steroids.
Yeah.
But, you know.
It sounds amazing.
It's really, really good.
Yeah, I was like thrown away.
Triple IPA, so smooth, so delicious.
The thing about it, too, was like, yeah, you get drunk, but like it's a euphoric drunk. I don't know if I said that yesterday.
No, you didn't.
That's what was about. What's so great about it, too, is like you're drinking, you get, you know, you have these beers that they're so fresh and good that like when you're finally buzzed or drunk or whatever, it's not like that sloppy blah blah blah. It's like almost like a body high, you know, like when you
almost like a wine drunk.
Oh yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. So you're in a good mood. It doesn't, you know, like once you drink enough fucking Bud Lights or you know, Miller's or something, you get full.
Yeah.
You feel like shit. Bloated. And even your head starts throbbing a little bit. You get like this head, you know, you start seeing double or whatever. Like, dude, I was fucked up, but I was still able to like talk, walk.
Yeah, it was amazing. It was seriously, amazing.
It was the way I could describe it. It was like being on edibles, kind of. You know, it was like a little bit of a body high.
The sativa of beers.
Sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
It was kind of incredible. I never noticed it before because I've always been drunk before I went in, and I had time to sober up before, and then.
Yeah, well, actually, the reason why we had to sober up before was because he spent the whole day at Lagunitas, and we actually got hooked the fuck up, dude.
Yeah,
we got hooked the fuck up over there.
Yeah, we did.
So how did you guys get hooked
up? We got hooked the fuck up. Well,
I know how you guys got hooked up. You just brought it up. We got hooked up, and then silence.
Yeah. Well, sorry, I was grabbing a beer. I needed
a beer. Well, you at least lob it over to me to make me help so I can describe it, not just hook the fuck up.
Ryan, that's you. Ryan.
Kind of shit show you guys running here.
Well, yeah, so thanks to my new hookups at the new... Azusa location for Lagunitas. We got hooked the fuck up. We got wristbands.
Lagunitas hooked the fuck up.
We got wristbands to get half off of all food and drink. And even the gift shop, surprisingly. We didn't expect. But when we walked in there, they saw our wristbands. And
what kind of stuff did they have in the gift shop, though?
Dude, they have everything.
Yeah?
Yeah, we got these t-shirts. I think he's wearing his. Are you wearing yours?
No. I'm not wearing mine right now, but it's the same one you got.
Yeah. Yeah. So we got t-shirts. They have t-shirts. They got soap. They got glasses. They have buttons. They have pins.
Like pins.
Everything. Koozies. Like they have.
Magnets, is it like their stickers. Own soap? Like they make their own soap?
Yeah.
Oh, that's fucking awesome.
Yeah. Everything.
Most breweries do.
Yeah.
Because it's like the leftover yeast, isn't it, or something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah. They. What was I going to say? Oh, they have basically like their own retail store with their own brand. You know, they even have like button down shirts, beanies, like merchandising. Lagunitas the flamethrower.
The kids love that one.
They have all kinds of shit, you know.
Mel Brooks.
And they give a lot of cool stuff out for free, which, you know, I brought some labels. They give you pens and you know, and everything's, you know, generously priced too. So you know, even a t-shirt, it's like $20.
All right.
Everything, you know, it's...
Yeah, t-shirts were $20. Pins were about, like, $3 to $5.
Well, and the beer there, I mean, people... Guys, when you go to fucking breweries, too...
Dude, beers are cheap.
They're cheap as fuck.
They're fucking cheap. Dude, beers were already $5, and we had wristbands for half off.
So we were getting $2.50
for a beer.
$2.50 a beer.
So we basically drank double of what we were already willing to spend. And then get this, we the chick that's that was there hooking us up tells us, you know, if the next people who are supposed to come into
she kind of made it seem like we weren't going to be able to get up in there. Because I mentioned it because that's what the guy had mentioned to me. He's like, yeah, you ever been in the loft? And I was like, no. He's like, it's pretty cool. He's like, I'll see if I can get you in there and blah, blah, blah. And, you know, we'll hook you up. We'll make sure you guys are taken care of. I'm like, okay. And so not knowing exactly what any of that means, you know, we just get there and they give us the wristband. And I said, he mentioned something about a loft. And they're like, oh, okay, well... We got some parties in there, but, you know, if something opens up, then we'll come look for you. Like, all right. So we decided to just sit and wait for the band to start. And Matt was going to go
on the tour.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't want to lose our seats. So I was like, fuck it. I'll just sit here. And then she comes down. And she's like, hey, so we can take you guys upstairs if you want. Just close out your tab and then We'll come get you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then we told her, like, oh, well, like, we're going to take a tour real quick. And she was like, oh, well, there's a VIP tour also.
Yeah, she's like, there's a VIP tour. We'll give you a private one.
Yeah.
Like,
all right.
It's awesome.
So we fucking, we got up. We, closed out our tabs, went up there. Drinks were already half off. We get inside. Drinks are fucking free in the VIP in the loft.
They're just like, we're like, I'm already fucking buzzed.
Yeah. I don't know how you guys walked out of this place conscious. 250 beers straight from the tap. Free beer on the fucking VIP tour.
Get this. You're actually the third person to fucking say that. Say those exact words to me. When I'm telling the story to everybody, that's exactly what they said.
Because I know if I was there, I'd be wrecked. Like, done. I need a wheelchair to get out of there.
I still had to drive back, too.
Yeah. Oh,
I decided to drive there because Ubers were taking too long and they were too expensive. So I was like, fuck it, I'll just drive.
I mean, we didn't expect, you know, to get...
I thought, you know, sure, a few free beers.
Yeah, like a free beer or two.
Full VIP treatment, half off of everything, and then free beer in the loft, and then free beer on the tour, and then, like...
Oh, dude, and then, the beer on the tour.
You can't say no. You can't say no.
Of course not.
Especially, I mean, I've never had beer straight, like you were telling me yesterday. Just finished.
Straight, yeah.
Oh, it's done.
Yeah.
Ready.
Yeah.
You just pour it out into your fucking...
Just tapped, yeah.
Yeah.
Just,
like, oh, my God. It just sounds amazing.
Not even, dude. No, that's the thing about it. It wasn't even tapped. Like, it was...
Well, the one that we got on the tour, yeah.
Yeah, it wasn't even... It was straight from the barrel of the finished product. Like,
yeah.
Like, we're going to put this in kegs now.
I kind of
like,
didn't expect it to be chilled already, though.
Dude, yeah, that's... a lot of people were asking, like, it's cold? I was like, dude, it's like, cold. It's so the coldest.
I guess they... I guess that's... Is that the process after they...
Yeah,
after
I guess they run it through another
coil.
They burn
it all,
yeah.
And they get it all fucking... Then they put it into the place where they're going to tap it. Or
yeah, and they throw it in cold, I guess, just to preserve it.
I guess, but
yeah.
Jesus.
Oh, man, amazing.
More, please.
Fuck. All right, well, I'm going to go ahead and call halftime right here. Just to give you folks at home what the next topic's going to be about, I'll give you a little taste. We're going to actually play the theme song for Power Rangers. So, yes, we're going to be talking about that.
Power Rangers.
So go ahead and enjoy this, the original theme. I can't remember who's the guy that wrote it and everything, but it's from Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. Go ahead, listen in and enjoy.
Did whatever happened to the era of coming live up with original songs?
Yeah.
And then it was also an original hit for whatever
for
band.
Whatever
this,
band.
This, this is like, you know what I mean? Like
that was a strictly like 90s thing.
80s dude, too. Yeah. 70s, 80s, and 90s did
yeah,
that.
It
like,
just,
they
yeah,
stopped.
And it, I mean, video games did it too. Like Duke Nukem had, I can't remember who they were, but that was like obviously their biggest hit because I do remember the song. That well,
then,
was the only song.
Then eventually Megadeth did it.
Yeah, Megadeth did it.
I mean,
well, no, actually, Megadeth did the first one.
They did?
Yeah, they did the very first one.
Oh, okay.
The one for Time to Kill is some other fucking band.
But I mean, even still for like movies, I mean, we like to make fun, but like Will Smith, like every movie Will Smith did, he
yeah,
had to
yeah,
have
yeah,
a rap song
exactly,
about that.
Exactly.
Or they would pay some band to like make a song. I guess
I mean,
they still kind of do
it.
It
still happens with movies, but remember there was a time where there'd be like a big band, like for instance, fucking Queen did Flash.
Yeah.
Flash Gordon.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Flash.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, yeah. Master of the universe.
You said Flash. I thought my mind went straight to DC.
No, Flash,
I'm like, Freddie Mercury was
Flash,
dead when that first
Flash
show
Gordon,
came on.
Sorry. Didn't specify. But
Flash Gordon, man.
That's what I mean. But like, that's also, that was a song that was played on the radio. Mm-hmm. Like,
yeah. Yeah, it was a huge hit.
I mean, Power Rangers never fucking was on the radio, but.
I mean,
no.
That, you get my point.
But yeah. It was a fucking dope ass song.
Hell yeah.
That was anyway,
that was the
Mortal Kombat theme song from that movie.
Oh, that became a cool techno song.
Yeah. It was big.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Input Ryan D theme. We're going to talk about some geeky shit, man. Power Rangers, bro. It's coming out.
That's Garrett's theme.
Yeah, I know.
Oh,
but
whatever.
We're going to make a new thing.
way to just fucking kill the mood.
Right? Sorry.
Jesus Christ.
Sorry.
Actually, that was Garrett's thing.
Garrett.
Actually.
Garrett came to mind. He immediately had to talk about it.
Worst podcast ever.
But, dude, I'm fucking. Are you okay?
What did I just drop?
I think cursor just fell.
Oh.
Oh.
Yeah, I was stuck on the bottom of it. the Power Ranger movie, man, like, it looks, I'm just so worried, because I know I've talked a bit about this on Humpcast before, all trailers that come out, for the most part, they all look amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
That's not always the case with a movie, and so I remember when the first trailer came out for this movie, I was just kind of like, whatever. Then when the second one came out, where they showed them in their suits, and they started showing the Zords, and Rita and Goldar, I was like, holy fuck, I need to see this movie.
Yeah.
Like, it's early 90s, I'm a kid again, and I'm coming home after school wanting to watch Power Rangers. Like,
I think one thing they're doing right about it, too, is they're not releasing so many trailers, teasers, and everything. Like, they literally had these two, you know, trailers that I've seen.
The last one they released was, like, to reinsure that you were going to get Zords.
Yeah.
Fucking Alpha 5.
Fucking
Zordon.
Yeah.
And the Megazord.
Mm-hmm. They got coins too. They're still coins. There might be rocks, but they're fucking coin shaped.
Like, I'm not a big, like, I get nostalgia, and I'm usually not a big fan of nostalgia. I think it's kind of like, sometimes it can be cheap. Like, we don't need to remake everything.
Yeah.
Or whatever. But this one, like, it fucking hit me hard. Then in the second trailer, like, I'm going.
But everything is so different, but they still hit it in every single way. Like, I got excited as fuck when I saw Zordon.
Yeah.
Like, dude, I knew, I was like, if they do a hologram, it's going to be really fucking cheap and tacky. Mm-hmm. Like, it's not going to be cool, especially if it's Bryan Cranston. Like, because you know what Bryan Cranston's face looks like. It's just going to be,
even if they did,
it's just going to be Hal in a hologram, dude.
Even if they did a hologram thing, it's just, the technology's there for these types of movies. I think it's as good as it's ever going to be.
But the whole like digital wall thing, like, that fucking blew my mind.
Yeah. I mean, that's a good way to do it too.
Yeah,
it's
like, dude, that's a great adaptation, man.
I've said it so many times before. They just can't go wrong, in my opinion. This TV show sucked. Like, watch it now when you're.
Oh God, yeah.
Of course,
yeah,
terrible.
That's just
super.
This
campy.
Is the kind of shit that I was talking about. Like, I get so sick of fanboys getting like so bent out of shape about these remakes and stuff. I'm like, do you realize how shitty that show was? Like,
how bad it was.
Like,
the acting and everything.
Even the martial arts wasn't that great. Like,
you know, as a matter of fact, it was originally a Japanese show, wasn't it?
Right. Yeah, they just dubbed over it. Yeah. Everything with the Power Rangers and the Zords was all Japanese.
Yeah.
And so everything with the kids was, you know, the only thing
they just added, like, you know, character.
Yeah, dude. So, like, even like Rita Repulsa's, like, when she talks and everything, it doesn't. She doesn't.
Not
she's
matched
not
up.
Saying it. It's not matched up or anything. Like, the reactions are really over the top and like fucking
ridiculous.
They
can only afford so much can't afford another actor to redo this. Just like, just use it. The kids are dumb. They
well, you
don't
know, Bryan Cranston's one of his first major roles. One of his early roles was doing a voiceover for one of the villains.
Oh, really?
In Power Rangers, yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it's just so crazy that now he's doing another voiceover, but for motherfucking Zordon, dude.
Yep.
That's amazing.
Full circle.
Yeah.
full circle.
I think that's why he said yes.
Yeah.
I would think. He seems like a great fucking dude, too.
Yeah. Cranston. I would really love to fucking meet Cranston. But actually, I pulled up this clip, and it's all I typed in was worst Mighty Morphin Power Rangers fight. And it was the first scene that I saw, and I watched it, a quick clip of it, and I was like, oh, my God, I need to save the rest of it because it is pretty intense.
Well, that's it.
First of all, bad acting. The mouth didn't match up with the words.
Oh, this is the one with the bad power engine.
Yeah, dude.
I remember this one. They like,
and then not only that, they're like, dude, that's like, I'm pretty sure that's like Boyle Heights or something. Like those hills and everything. Or like Whittier Narrows.
No.
Like they're in just some, yeah, dude.
Well, this is when they started shooting their own. This was like third season.
They had their own budget. Like, yeah. Well, they had to settle with their own budget.
That's why the people who were actually doing the show, they're actually fighting them.
I know your moves better than you do. Man, these guys are hardcore.
All right, we're gonna watch the whole clip.
It gets better, dude. I swear. Just the acting, man. The exquisite acting.
Exquisite. You know, God, and this guy that I'm like, I want to unfollow him more and more. The guy that plays Tommy. The Green Ranger.
Yeah, what's his name? Jason David Frank. Yeah.
He's such a douche.
Yeah.
He's such a douche.
He's really kind of full of himself and
yeah, like he was nice when we met him at Comic-Con, but he was on his way to his booth.
Yeah.
And
he kind of talked to me at my booth.
Yeah, he was like that. Like, you guys come to the booth? We're like, yeah, of course. And he was like, okay, well, I'll see you there. And I was like, you know, like kind of, I didn't really think too much about it because I was so excited, you know, to meet him and shit. And then, that's pretty much how this guy makes all of his paychecks now because he's a terrible actor, obviously.
Yeah. What else has he been in?
He is a martial artist for real, though.
Yeah.
And he also did some MMA.
He does stunts. Like,
well, I know when like CM Punk like had that UFC fight or got that UFC contract, like he was big. Like he really wanted to like fight CM Punk for some reason. I don't know if they had beef or whatnot.
Really?
Probably.
Yeah. But yeah, he wanted to be like CM Punk's like first MMA fight.
Well, I don't know how good his MMA career was.
I don't know. Finding some like low level organizations.
You mean CM Punk or this guy?
No, this guy, Jason David Frank.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah. So, and he's kind of a Jesus freak too.
Really? Is
yeah.
He?
Yeah. So that's why what you brought up was that short. Somebody brought up the short. The Power Rangers. So he was avidly trying to get it off the internet, said it was disgusting and that's not what the Rangers are about. It's a kid's show and everybody ought to be ashamed of themselves.
On. Like, get out of here. Just let people enjoy what they enjoy. Like, just stop it.
Sure.
Stop it.
I mean, really what it was somebody else was excited for a new fucking Tommy. I think that's what it was.
And then he came out with a video on Instagram too saying like, you know, I saw the new Rangers trailer and it looks good. I just hope, you know, they stay true to the what did he say? Some shit like that. And he was like, I just really wish they you know, asked me to be a part of it. You know, nobody came and asked me.
God. And do what?
Dude, yeah, this guy seriously believes he is the fucking Green Ranger.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, I'm serious.
Well, he was the Green Ranger. He was a Red Ranger. He was a Black Ranger. And
the White Ranger.
The White Ranger.
Yeah.
So he's gotten like... So he's been in so many different things, and he was the star. Let's not forget that he was on a couple of different
people thought
he was the shit. But I mean, I remember Tommy was my favorite.
Billy was
my favorite because I was a little dorky kid. He was like the science guy, but it could also beat everybody up. I was like, that's dope. That's my guy. Mm-hmm. And everybody made fun of me because I was Billy. I was like, Billy, every time we played Power Rangers in the front yard, I was Billy.
Oh, yeah, guess who I was every time I played Power Rangers?
Of course you were fucking Zach,
no
dude.
No matter what, Black Ranger every time.
Of course you were.
Couldn't fight for nothing else.
You'd be the same at my house.
No, actually, I mean, I did kind of notice, though, they did still keep to the original lineup. There was an Asian guy who was a Black Ranger. And the Power Rangers for a while.
Sure.
Well, yeah.
That was when they switched it up.
Yeah, once they realized what they did, it's like, oh, shit, the Black Ranger's black. The Asian Ranger's yellow. Yeah. Like, oh, shit.
That was when around the time, the season before the movie came out was when they recast the Black Ranger and the Yellow Ranger. And the Pink Ranger, I think. Yeah. Which one died? Some of them, the Yellow Ranger died.
Yellow Ranger.
Actually, no, so the Pink Ranger was still there. Yeah, so they recast the Red Ranger and the Black Ranger.
That's why I liked in the trailer, you know, that throwaway line where they were like in the water.
He's like, I'm black.
It's like, I'm black. It's like, no, you're not.
It's so funny.
Dude, I feel like that is also such a nod to like the old classic. Like,
yeah.
I mean, it looks fucking good, dude. It looks really amazing. And I can't wait for this to come out. It comes out next month. It's already here.
Just be okay. Just please be okay. Like,
it's going to be fine, man.
I'm so sick of just getting bamboozled by fucking trailers. Like, oh, shit, this looks awesome. And going in, it's like, God damn it.
Batman v Superman takes the fucking cake, man.
Suicide Squad, Batman vs. Superman.
Well, I think you hated Suicide Squad more than I did.
Yeah, I did.
It's just
Suicide Squad.
I'm just so frustrated with
it. Wasn't
that
good, but you know, it was a fun movie. I had fun in the movie.
Yeah, like it was a decent movie. I'll give it that. Like, there's just a lot of things I always get back to the
stupid movie because Batman v Superman, when I was in there, I audibly went, no fucking way. Like audibly in the fucking, like in the audience watching the movie when some shit went, I was like, Martha, no fucking way, dude.
Yeah,
like,
God. Just please, like, can Wonder Woman? I know Wonder Woman's coming. Please, just get the ship in the right direction. All I want is a fucking great DC movie. And I've heard some bad. I've heard some bad things about Wonder Woman online. Fucking Batman looks like it's falling apart. The Flash is falling apart, and it's just like,
yeah.
Oh, why?
DC just needs to get out of their fucking head. Like, you're not going to be Marvel, DC. You will never be Marvel.
This is exactly what we talked about yesterday.
I was telling Ryan yesterday. What I think the problem is, WB needs a hit. Harry Potter's done. They need their tentpole. They need these movies to do great, you know, for them.
That's true.
I think because of that, there's too many cooks in the kitchen. There's too many people trying
too many
to...
Cooks?
Too many cooks.
There's too many people trying to make decisions, and it's fucking everything up. Like, what was it? The Flash has gone through, what, two or three different directors now? Ben Affleck dropped out of directing Batman. It just seems like there's...
Well, then that rumor started, which is what we talked about yesterday.
Yeah, then there's a rumor.
There's a rumor going around, and this dude is on a movie podcast that he just heard from a dude who heard from a dude that...
I knew a dude disguised as another dude.
That Ben Affleck just wants to be done with the whole thing altogether.
Yeah. But I just
I feel like, yeah.
The source material that DC has, like, they get it right everywhere else. The fucking cartoon movies they do... Blow Marvel out of the water. They're amazing.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
I love them. I love them. Yeah. The TV shows, I didn't like Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., but like Arrow had a slow start for me, but it's brought me back on. The Flash, I think, is good.
I had to stop watching The Flash.
You didn't like it?
I don't like it at all.
I fucking love The Flash. I love The Flash.
It got really Dawson's Creek-y for me, and then I was like, all right, I'm out.
Well, it's on the CW, so they're going to have that, and I'll give it a pass
for
that.
But like every time, like, look, every I get it.
Right, will they, won't they? Like, shut the fuck up.
Yeah,
like,
just,
I want to see Flash like, do Flash shit.
I want to see Flash do Flash shit. Yeah, exactly. I mean, it gets cool. It's got its cool moments, and then I
But
have, like
I'll give it a pass. And even Supergirl's all right.
Also, it's probably because I watched like 6 episodes in one day. So maybe I just got like...
Oh, you got overloaded.
I got overwhelmed with like...
Just the cheese.
Yeah, but really, I mean... You really need to tell me who you are.
Yeah. I could sit there and watch 8 episodes of fucking Daredevil,
That's true, man. Because like, I watched the whole entire season of Daredevil like twice.
Yeah.
Like,
Daredevil's on another level.
That show is so fucking good.
Yeah.
And it's I don't know what happened. Daredevil doing Daredevil shit.
Look, I love Daredevil, and I really like Jessica Jones.
I haven't started watching that one.
Fucking, did you watch Luke Cage?
No. I started watching it. I was like, Jesus Christ.
Like, what happened? It's fucking terrible.
What's wrong with it?
Like, for me, like, especially the first couple episodes, it was just like, all right, this was obviously written by a white dude who doesn't know any black people. Some white dude was sitting at his computer like, this is how black people talk. And it was just cringeworthy. Like, the conversations they were having in the barbershop.
Yo, brother.
He's like, cut me some slack, Jack.
Yeah. And it was just like, Jesus Christ. Like, I get they were trying to do the exploitation thing.
Oh, shit.
But it was fucking just cringeworthy. And I forced myself to finish it. But it was just bad. It was bad.
Oh,
that sucks. I haven't watched Luke Cage, man.
But you saw Jessica Jones, right?
I haven't watched the Jessica Jones.
Jessica Jones is good.
Because I haven't heard anything about it. Like, I haven't heard anybody talking about it. Like, a lot of people told me, they're like, dude, you'd feel fucking loved.
Jessica Jones is good. David Tennant is really fucking good in this as the main villain.
Again, another... The problem with these shows and Jessica Jones' character is I don't know anything.
Okay, case in point, right here.
Exactly, and that's what I was about to say.
Yeah,
but it's me being me, and so it's like when I see something, like, I don't fucking know who that is. I don't care.
Yeah,
but like, I'm sure the show is amazing. Guardians of the Galaxy, I didn't know anything about until like the movie came. Like, I heard of them, maybe saw like a comic book back in the day, but like never. I'm like, okay, there's a fucking giant tree and a raccoon and a green lady.
like, what a really buff dude.
Yeah, like, whatever. And then, like, the trailers came out. I was like, this looks fucking awesome.
Yeah.
And then
I just think they did it right. Like, they really did justice with
Guardians. Well, here's what we were talking about before, too, is that Marvel has the power because they don't have, you know, the rights to the X-Men or Fantastic Four. So they have, like, and those are big.
Yeah, those were their number ones. X-Men and Spider-Man were their number one selling.
So since they don't have those rights, this is what they're doing. They're reaching back. They're getting some unknown shit that nobody knows. Nobody gave
a shit about Iron Man when that movie first came out.
And then they create a badass movie, you know? Like,
yeah.
And it's, you know, and they've been, exactly, Iron Man too.
Iron Man came out, especially. Nobody, he was a third-rate character. Nobody gave a fuck about Iron Man. Now everybody loves him.
I only knew of Iron Man because of Spider-Man. Like, that was
I had one Iron Man comic when I was a kid.
I never had Iron Man comics. I had X-Men comics and Spider-Man comics. Yeah. And
X-Men, Spider-Man. I've read a couple Iron Man comics.
But I was a huge fan of the Spider-Man, the 90s Spider-Man cartoon.
Oh, yeah, of course.
So... I mean, hooked, man. Like, every fucking time there was an episode.
Getting out of school.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Saturday morning. It was on Saturday morning. And, you know, an Iron Man and War Machine would show up in certain episodes.
Yeah.
And that's what I remember. I remember Iron Man trying to get Spider-Man to join the Avengers.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And so that's...
I remember the Incredible Hulk. That's one that I remember. What?
No, the Incredible Hulk had its own show.
Yeah, it had its own show.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I remember that, too. And then Batman and Superman, you know.
Justice League.
Yeah.
What? I don't know.
My point is, I knew who Iron Man was, but you're right. It was like a second-rate character.
That's how I knew who Captain America was, though, was through The Incredible Hulk.
Yeah. And see, that's a funny thing about me, because I think most people know now because of the movies, Captain America, Steve Rogers. I remember I found out when I was a kid.
That's his name, Steve Rogers.
Yeah, I found out when I was a kid reading some book, and they had like, or I used to collect the comic cards when I was a kid, and I remember I had it, and I would just read all their characters' bios. So I'm like, holy shit, like, I have the same name as Captain America. That's amazing. It was the best day of my life as a second grader.
Until the movie came out.
You know? And then, nobody fucking knew. And then the movie came out. Now people realize it all the time. Like, I can go anywhere, use my debit card. People wouldn't say shit. After, like, the first movie came out, and really, after Winter Soldier came out, whenever I used my cards, I was like, isn't that Captain America's name? Like, yeah. Like, before it was cool. Before the movies came out, where I would say someone, like, I would say my name, and someone's like, oh, it's Captain America. I'm like, oh, my people. Like, okay, like, we can be friends, but now it's just fucking everybody.
Yeah, yeah.
The cashier at fucking Rite Aid. Yeah. Isn't that Captain America's name? I'm like, yeah, it is.
You're like, yeah, bitch, read some comics.
Yeah. Well, it was actually crazy. Well, for me at least. Obviously, my name is Steve Rogers. His name is Captain America.
Now you're getting too close to the mic. are you going to be there or close?
We'll leave it right
okay,
there.
Okay, never mind.
And then the movie actually came out on my birthday. Like the first Captain America movie, which which is like a cool thing for me, you know? Like, oh shit, he was never my favorite character, but it was like, oh, that's kind of fucking awesome. First Captain America movie on my birthday.
Oh, go ahead. Sorry.
No, that was it.
I just what I love about the movies is that they do point out the fact that Captain America is kind of just a you know, a little bit of a fucking trophy hero or whatever.
Oh,
like,
absolutely.
Like the way Iron Man, like Stark just makes fun of him so much. Because that's why that's what turns me off from those characters. Like, I never like Superman. I never like Captain America because they're too perfect.
Yeah.
You know? Mm-hmm. Like, do-gooders, whatever. You know, like Batman was always the best because he was a crazy person. Yeah. If you think about it.
Because
you know?
He didn't do good just to do good. I mean, he had a reason.
He had vengeance.
That
yeah.
In the same.
He was angry.
Spider-Man, like.
Spider-Man. The Uncle Ben dying, you know.
Yeah.
He had some
it's funny with Spider-Man. I feel like it was different, like, because he already had the powers before Uncle Ben died.
Yeah, but he didn't give a shit.
That's sure, but he wasn't
wrestler.
Really a hero until that happened.
Yeah. After his uncle died, it was just like, oh man, like I
that's
like,
why that
go,
that's why that quote,
like,
is so relevant, because it was the last thing he told him before he went.
Yeah,
and,
with great power. Yeah,
with great power comes great responsibility. Right.
They didn't.
So that's why that's why they emphasize that in the cartoons, which I rewatched recently, is because you know, they emphasize that there's a lot of those flashbacks. They'll flashback a lot to that because he says ever since that happened to Uncle Ben, he would never let it happen to anybody else. So that's, I mean, he does have that battle between what's good, what's not, you know, and all that stuff.
Yeah.
But also, he's still a kid, so.
Oh, yeah, he's high school.
So that's what, Spider-Man always resonated with me so much. He was always my favorite.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is this Spider-Man still in high school?
Yeah.
Tom Holland?
Yeah.
Really? No way.
You didn't see the trailer?
Yeah, Homecoming.
It's a high school. I know. I didn't even notice. All I paid attention to was the spider suit.
Yeah,
and
they're in high school. He's like, what?
I'm really high when I watch this show.
Oh my god! Yes, dude. He's in high school and he's chasing the girl, which isn't Mary Jane. For there's a bottle.
Dude, yeah. I know. Can you believe that? Like, people freaked out so bad that they had to change her name.
There's a bottle opener right there.
Is she? What did they change her name to? Or are they doing that thing where they're just hiding it? And
they had to change
Mary
her
Jane?
Name right there on hooking on.
Here, there's.
Oh, here it is. Okay.
What do you mean they had to change her name?
Yeah, I thought that's what it was. Like, they said, no, Mary Jane's going to be a black girl. And people were like,
No. What happened was.
No, they wanted to do a different.
They casted Zendaya. And so everyone assumed, like, oh, shit, this is Mary Jane. You know,
okay.
But her character, where
I thought it was
listed,
just like people were freaking out. Like,
well, they did freak out because that's what everyone thought. Like,
yeah.
They cast her, so everyone thought she's.
Which, by the way, who fucking cares?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean,
Trump's America, bro. This is what happens.
Mary
people
Jane's,
freak
sure,
out.
Mary
who
Jane's
the fucking
gonna fucking. This is the kind of shit that I'm talking about, dude. Like, yeah. I mean, I love original comics and the original stories and all that stuff. But like, you can't. You can make changes. It's fine.
Yeah,
like,
it's fine.
Remember, a lot of these characters were created in the 60s
in the fucking,
when there was
exactly.
a lot of, like, it's okay. Like, the
exactly.
Black Panther. Like, Black Panther, what a lot of people don't know, came before the actual Black Panthers. And so when the Black Panthers got popular, they changed Black Panther comic book. They changed
to
it to
black
the Black.
Guy?
No, they changed it to the Black Leopard.
Oh.
Because they didn't want to be associated with Panthers. And then once all that came down, then they went back to Black Panther.
Interesting. Yeah, I didn't know that.
But, I mean, you're in the time. But it's not, like, the only thing I question about the Spider-Man Homecoming casting.
Sorry, I was just, like, picturing, like, picture Black Panther in, like, a leather jacket, a bunch of patches and everything.
I'm sorry I ruined your Black Panther party.
But the only casting that bothered me was just physical reasons. The guy they got for a Flash Thompson. Like this little skinny Indian kid
for this new one,
really?
Yeah, it was weird. I'm like, that's odd, but
that's strange.
But I'm like, fuck it, I trust them at this point. Like they'll find a way to make it.
So
work.
Funny, we were rewatching the Sam Raimi Spider-Man.
Dude, it's fucking Brad from How I Met Your Mother.
Exactly.
Joe, what's his last name?
John Mangini.
Mandolinero.
The guy who does the perfect Randy Macho Man Savage.
Yes,
fucking impression.
Yes,
greatest fucking thing in the world. They need to make a biopic of Macho Man. Man.
Yes.
Or just
and
wrestling.
And cast him.
No, fuck that. Just do a movie about wrestling in the 80s with Hogan and fucking Andre the Giant,
yeah.
Macho Man, Ultimate Warrior. Make that fucking movie. Make that movie. And Joe Manchin, whatever the fuck his name is.
Yeah.
Ran as fucking Macho Man.
Fuck yeah, dude.
Manchin, is it Manchinello?
Dude,
what?
That's a freaking brilliant idea.
Yeah,
write
right.
It.
Why
dude,
haven't
what?
They?
Yeah.
You're welcome, Hollywood.
Yeah. Yeah, there you go. Pay me.
That is a fucking brilliant idea. Are you kidding me?
Just yeah. Them all coked out in the fucking
yeah, exactly.
In the back.
Oh, yeah. The cream of the crop.
Fuck yeah, dude. Just do a movie about the 80s wrestling, man. That would have been
nothing.
That'd be crazy.
Ooh,
yeah. But yeah, don't make it like dark. Like, make it fun. Like, let's see backstage shit, you know? Them working out.
Where they're all coked
out. They're all just coked out, like, waiting to do their interview. Just doing mountain lines of cocaine.
Oh, yeah, brother.
Pure athlete, yeah. Like the cream of the crop.
The best part about it though is that when they're like that when they're on camera. What if off camera they're just like, so how's it going today? How's it going today, Terry?
I highly doubt it. Yeah. They all just racked up some fatties. They did it with like both nostrils on the bench in the gym. Just like two lines, just two lines, and went across the fucking bench.
And then just did a bunch of bench presses.
This is Flash Thompson.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's strange to me, but I'm like, yeah, they'll make it work.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, I guess.
They'll make it work.
It doesn't matter.
I mean,
I
guess it's your modern day bully. Like, it doesn't have to be a
probably,
big tough guy
yeah,
now.
Sure. Probably do some like cyberbullying.
Especially,
yeah.
I mean, maybe. I mean, look, it could be a good thing because Tom Holland's kind of a little. I mean, he comes off as a pretty scrawny, weakling guy.
Yeah.
So, I mean, if. You kind of want to match that. You don't want to have him over the top tough, right?
Yeah, no. No good workout.
Makes sense.
Better than Topher Grace.
Topher Grace wasn't Flash Thompson.
No, but he was Eddie Brock. And
yeah.
And
Eddie Brock, that's the one thing in a movie that, in a comic book movie that I really was like, are you fucking kidding me? like, I don't care, you know. There was a black Harvey Dent in the fucking in the early Batman
the early
movies.
Batman's, yeah.
Like, no one, I don't give a fuck about the but the one thing the one thing like it's just this guy so needed to be a tough guy. Like,
yeah.
he was Peter Parker's bully outside of fucking high school. Like,
yeah,
this scrawny asshole is gonna be Venom, bro. Like,
yeah.
Dude, I mean, if you think about it too, Joe, what's his name, would have been perfect to bring back at that point, like, because he was already bodybuilding and everything, like,
yeah,
he was getting huge.
Wait, Flash Thompson has been Venom before, right?
Later, yeah.
Yeah.
He becomes, actually, Flash Thompson becomes Agent Venom.
Agent Venom, yeah.
That's right. And yeah. Then I think Flash was also in Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yeah.
As
yeah.
Agent Venom.
As Agent, yeah. Yeah.
Because he loses his legs, he goes to war.
That's right.
He loses his ability to walk, and as a government experiment, they give him the symbiote. He's able to walk again. He has these superhuman strength, but he has to constantly battle the evil. In order to be a hero, and then and he's the only one who can actually help the Guardians at that point too.
Yeah, it's all this fucking crazy ass story after that, dude.
Oh God, that's why. I mean, Marvel.
I
want
to read that one, dude.
They can go on.
Agent Venom?
Yeah. Agent Venom.
Well,
he's
got a whole
series.
Yeah,
with
the Guardians.
With
the Guardians. That's just...
Oh, goddamn. Volume 2. I can't wait.
It looks awesome.
Volume 2.
Yes. It looks awesome, and it's going to tie into the fucking
Infinity
War.
Infinity Wars. Yeah. Dude, Ragnarok is coming out. Oh.
Yeah, here's the thing, man. What was the last Thor movie called?
The Dark World.
Dark World.
Dark World.
Yeah. I don't remember it. Like,
It was very forgettable. Yeah.
Like, like, I know it was something that kind of buffered between the two movies. That's what I was saying yesterday when we were comparing.
Actually, it was more a nod to Guardians, I guess, because it said that it was split. It was dimensions. It was dimensions lining up, and that he was going to collapse them all down and bring them down.
I got to rewatch it because I saw it in theaters, and it was a very forgetful film.
Yeah.
I don't.
So basically, it was the doorways of all the different to. The Guardians,
sure.
And I guess, you know, whoever, whatever,
all the different worlds,
and all the different worlds, yeah.
Well, where every Infinity Stone came from, right? Like,
no, I don't think so. That's the thing, I don't remember. Oh. Like, I've watched.
I don't
it
remember.
Yeah. I've watched it twice, and I.
I know it had something to do with the Infinity Stones, right?
Yeah.
Well, one of the Infinity Stones, which was actually broken, it's not even a stone.
Like
it's like
red
a
liquid.
Yeah, it's like a
right.
liquid.
Right. Right. All of them are kind of about the Infinity Stones, pretty much. Right?
Yeah.
But what I've been hearing is that the first Infinity War is going to be like a Guardians type movie.
Yeah.
Like it's going to take place in their universe, and then they're going to collide at the end, and then the second movie is them joining the Avengers pretty much. It's kind of what I'm hearing. That the part two of Infinity War.
Well, I mean, isn't it like the first days of filming already? I mean, and they're already
sure, but that doesn't necessarily mean that's going to be the first movie.
You don't know what order they're filming this thing in.
Yeah, that's true.
From what I hear, the Guardians are going to be like the main focus of the first film.
Yeah,
and the Avengers are the second.
Well, let's kind of speculate then, because we do have the little bit.
Oh, the first that, one. Oh yeah, you guys haven't seen this.
Oh,
yeah.
I haven't seen this yet.
Before creation itself, there were six singularities. Forged into infinity stones.
This is our first day. Here we are in Pinewood in Atlanta, and it's actually pretty unbelievable.
Yeah,
day
the three
one
of, them.
Of what promises to be a year of fun-filled lensing.
I remember actually going to see the first Avengers with one of my best mates from home, and I'd never have dreamed that I'd ever
so be funny hearing him like
yeah,
that.
His voice threw me off.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm on top of the world because this is just mind-blowing.
Last Spider-Man was English too.
Andrew Garfield.
What we always try to do at Marvel Studios is we're building the cinematic universe, is look at the big picture.
Fucking
how
Kevin
can things
Feige.
Relate across movies and across years? Avengers Infinity War is the culmination of the entire Marvel Cinematic Universe as started in May of 2008 with the release of Iron Man 1. And it really is an unprecedented culmination of a series of films interlinked together, which at the time had never been done before. And for us, the important thing is making it all come together. We know they're going to face Thanos. We've been setting that up since Avengers 1. How do you do that in a way that is unexpected, that pits the Avengers against somebody who is more powerful than anyone they've faced, and yet make them completely unprepared to face him? Well, tear them apart, which is why we did Civil War before Infinity War.
As we were conceiving and executing Civil War, the end of that movie was very much a setup for what these movies would be. We always had the sense of that.
Oh, God.
Tony is not talking to Steve. The Avengers are basically a name with nobody in it. The world is vulnerable.
Tony senses this greater threat approaching, and so he is doing everything in his power to keep the Earth safe.
Thanos shows us why he's the biggest, the best, the baddest villain that we've ever had, and the most frightening villain that the Avengers have ever faced.
The most exciting part is the incredible roster of well-developed characters, and that's going to create a really combustible, exciting, massive-scale adventure.
You know that we're onto something within the studio when we hit upon an idea or we see a piece of concept art and all of us in the room go, this is cool. And in Avengers Infinity War, the Avengers will meet the Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yes!
Holy fuck,
dude. Because of what Marvel is, because of what they have done over the last 10 years, these next two Avengers films will be an event like no one has ever seen on film before.
Oh my God. Motherfucker.
Fuck, man.
I gotta pee because my dick's hard.
But dude, Oh shit, man. Like I can't fucking believe that.
Yeah, I cannot wait.
Oh my god.
Like I can't, there's no words. Like you know it's gonna be amazing. Joe and Anthony Russo, they're directing it. They directed, you know, Winter Soldier and Civil War, which were great. I think Winter Soldier hands down is, probably like my favorite comic book movie. Favorite superhero
Winter
movie.
Soldier?
Winter Soldier. I loved it. They did an amazing job. And just knowing that they're behind this and like everyone that's bringing in, everyone we love, the Guardians of the Galaxy are amazing.
Oh, fuck yeah,
they're
dude.
Coming in there. Like,
I seriously can't wait.
Holy shit, like this movie's going to be epic. So
and it's got all of them there already. Like this is happening. This is the next step. Like,
yeah, we're gonna have 5 hours basically, a 2-part movie. It's probably gonna be 5 hours of just the greatest thing that could ever happen.
Yeah,
you know.
Oh man, just, I seriously cannot wait for this to come out. It looks so good. Like
just growing up, like being that little fucking nerdy kid who loved comic books and always like, oh man, I wish I could do a comic book movie. And see like where they started to where we are now, like yeah. this.
I mean,
just like holy shit.
So I mean, obviously Spider-Man wasn't the first, you know, comic movie, but I feel like it was probably the one with Tobey Maguire.
Yeah, no, they had a Captain America movie that he did in the 90s with J.D. Salinger's kid. He played Captain America.
Really?
Yeah, it's god awful. It's fucking terrible. Like, I want you to look it up. There's a scene where Captain America like does this twice in this fucking movie where he wants to steal someone's car, and so he's driving around with somebody, and then he pretends to be sick, gets out of the car, walks down the street, pretend like he's gonna throw up, and the other person walks up to check up on him, and then he sprints back to the car and jumps in the car. And steals these people's car.
Fucking thief.
And he does this twice in the fucking movie. They're just driving. He's like, I think I'm going to be sick.
Oh, my God.
And they pull over and he fakes sick. And the other person gets out. He jumps in the car and takes off.
Well, how about in Civil War, he just throws himself on someone's windshield. That they pull over, like, what the fuck? And then he pulls them out of the car and then jumps in and kicks the windshield in.
That is more believable. If you can find this clip.
Like, nobody talks about this when I watched this recently, I'm like, he just stole that woman's car.
Wait, Matt, pull up, just try to search on YouTube I think it came out in, like, 89. 89 or
what 90, is it?
91, the original, like, one of the original Captain America movies.
Oh, shit.
It is fucking terrible. He was, like, a kid with polio. And it was just got same dude with just with a limp, like it was terrible.
Yeah,
but just to see like where movies have come from, like superhero movies from like that. Just
is it? I think I found it. Hold on.
That's it.
Move it over here.
It's just like what is going on. But yeah, from this, yeah, just let it play.
I think I'm gonna be sick. Would you please pull over the car? I am going to get sick.
Oh, okay, all right.
Like, you're Captain America. He gets car sick.
I know.
Fuck out of here.
Just, he steals this guy's fucking car.
Just wait.
In the fucking
just
forest.
Wait. Just wait. Like, I mean, the suit is on point. 2.0.
It is on point, dude.
It's exact from the comic books, and it looks terrible.
It looks like it looks like it's painted on.
Yeah, it's a fake rubber suit. And the thing is, like when he had the hood on, he couldn't hear, so they had to put fake ears on his hood.
Are you okay? Boy,
he doesn't even run that.
Just a fucking
what an asshole.
He fucking stole that guy's car.
Just like an
American.
That's
his move. Can you pull over? I'm going to get sick.
Just like an American.
Taking advantage of a little guy and then leaving him stranded.
Oh, my God.
Man, Captain America's a motherfucker.
Are you okay? Oh, shit. He's doing it again.
Yeah. Fucking worst thing. Like, we've come so far from that bullshit to fucking like Infinity War. It is terrible.
Oh man. You know what's cool too, which I don't think it's pointed out enough,
uh-huh,
is the costuming in these new movies with the you know, with Marvel.
Oh, yeah.
Is that you think about how shitty, you know, how they're going to play that in some comics, you know, the suits are just ridiculous.
Yeah.
I mean, Iron Man's original suit was literally made out of iron.
Yeah.
And he was just a clunky guy who walked around in a metal suit and he looked like shit. And now it's one of the most iconic superheroes. And then, and so what they do with Captain America actually originally in the first movie. He gets in the first movie of the Marvel Universe. He gets that spangly outfit, and becomes
with
like
the
a mascot.
Wings on the ears,
yeah, exactly. And now he still sort of has that outfit, but it's a war helmet, and the wings are painted on the side, and
they're engraved on the side.
Yeah, exactly.
And
so
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Yeah, and then the Spider-Man suit. This new Spider-Man suit, dude.
dude, throwback, way back.
I mean,
to the fucking wings.
Well, when we saw this last trailer for Homecoming, he's got the Spidey wings, but he didn't have those in Civil War.
No.
So Tony Stark gave him this suit, but with the adjustable eyes.
They expand. Yeah.
Which is like something that gets like really looked over in that movie. Is how amazing that suit is and the effects of him with...
Yeah, because that's how it is in the comic. The comics is really just to show the emotion.
Sure,
but it looks great.
Yeah.
Like, I'm glad they really incorporated that.
You can see the emotion now.
Yeah, in his eyes. Exactly. It's amazing. God, it's amazing Spider-Man.
I know, like we were saying, like a lot of suits... You know, they can work for the comic book, but if you try to take them over verbatim, they look... Ugh.
Sure, they look terrible. Sometimes.
You know, like that Captain America clip we just watched. Like, that's what his suit
but
is.
But that's what they do a version of that in Captain America. I mean, he's had like seven different suits over these last couple movies.
But I just wish they would fucking do it for the X-Men.
Yeah.
They did. What pissed me off on one I felt like was a middle finger to all of us was when they did it at the end of Apocalypse.
No, they
where
did
they
it.
Had him at, they, where they had them all in the
but
suits.
But they partially did it in... What's the fucking the first one? God damn it! First Class.
Okay, yeah.
They partially did it in blue and yellow.
Yeah, so I thought that was cool. I thought they'll go, but then Bryan Singer and his fucking all leather.
Mm-hmm.
They have like pink and blue trim. Like fuck you.
Yeah,
we know what we want. Or like in the Wolverine where they showed his suit, but it was in a deleted scene that they added in on the DVD. It's like find a way and make it work.
Like, even if they did like the later version of it, which was like black and yellow.
Yeah.
Like that would be cool too.
I just want to see Hugh Jackman. Cuz
wasn't it like blue and yellow first or
no, it was like brown. They have a yellow and brown, they have blue and yellow. It's changed.
Blue and yellow, brown and yellow, black and yellow. It's like got all these different ones.
Yeah, Wolverine's changed a bit. But I want to see Hugh Jackman in the suit. Please have a flashback.
No, we're not gonna have it at all.
Just
wait. Actually, what if Hugh Jackman does one more appearance as Wolverine, but in Deadpool?
I'd be happy if he's in a suit. Put him in a fucking suit.
That's what I'm saying. What if then what if Deadpool like makes fun of him for being in the suit? Like, oh, what? You can wear it in any of the other movies? Yeah, like,
that would be perfect.
That'd be perfect.
I would.
Because
really enjoy
this. Didn't you see? There's a tweet that Hugh Jackman posted. It's him, Ryan Reynolds, and it's Pierce Brosnan.
Is Pierce Brosnan going to be Cable?
That's what they're talking about.
I don't know about that.
If he can not be so fucking British, I think it'd be great.
I know they talked about like were the John Hamm, and I was cool.
John
with that.
Hamm would be great.
Yeah,
I still think fucking
the dude from Avatar.
No,
I
what's
think
his name? God, the wrestler.
Mickey Rourke.
No, John no, Cena? No. The big blonde wrestler. God damn it.
Ric Flair.
Not
Ric Triple H.
Oh, fuck, man. NWO. WCW.
Rick Nash.
Kevin Nash. Yes. He tweeted out a picture.
He would be pretty good.
After the success of Deadpool. He tweets out a picture. He's like, hey, you guys still looking for somebody to cast as Cable? And it's him standing next to a poster of Cable.
And it looks, it's so dead on.
And I was like, dude, yes!
Dude, Kevin Nash is such a terrible actor. Dude,
I don't give a fuck. He's so fucking I don't give
bad.
A fuck. I want to see it.
He's so
put
bad.
Hulk Hogan there. I don't care. I'm just kidding. Oh, yeah.
Oh, shit, dude. Well, I mean, we've already gone on for an hour. I totally forgot to... let everybody know who Steve was. Steve, why don't you tell us a little bit about
it? My name is Steve Rogers.
Captain America. Hey.
Yeah. I am a writer. I guess you could say. I guess I can start calling myself a director now since I am directing a TV pilot that
I wrote.
Not
until you direct it.
It's Tuesday. Yeah, what is that? Like 5 days?
Sure. 5 days?
Yeah. First day.
Is that really the first day?
Yeah, Tuesday night.
Next week, right?
Yeah, we're filming at the Rendezvous in Covina.
I'm going to have to bail on the podcast, probably.
No, because we don't start shooting until, like, call time's like 1:30.
In the morning?
Yeah, a.m.
Ooh.
Yeah, no, it's going to be a late nighter.
All right.
1:30 a.m. till about, like, maybe 9.
I'll be there, dude.
In the morning, but yeah, I wrote
He's going to be there all drunk.
I wrote a TV pilot. I'm filming it right now. We got some funding. I threw some of my own money. We got a great cast. You know, I got a great crew behind me, which is just fucking amazing.
Fortunate.
Yeah, I've worked with some shit.
I'm really
people.
Looking forward to it, man. It looks, I mean, I've read over the script about twice. It's real funny.
Yeah, no, yeah. We were doing some test shoots today. We were going over the scene in the one of the scenes in the bar. And yeah, the jokes are hitting. And so yeah, pretty confident about this. Should be pretty
there
good.
There you go. Nice, you know? Nice. And this is actually for a project also?
Well, you could say it's my senior project, but like I wrote this thing a while ago. And so it's just kind of like I'm not going to say passion project, but it was just a funny idea that I got for a TV show. And to compare it, I would say it's a cross between like Clerks and It's Always Sunny. And so
It's Always Sunny, Clerks.
Yeah.
And it's Always Sunny for Clerks in Los Angeles.
And so
new title, there it is.
Yeah, the script has gone over a couple of rewrites, but I think it's strong now, and I'm really looking forward to doing that. Getting started.
And Senor Ryan D is starring in it as well.
Yeah, Ryan D is going to be the second lead.
Co-star.
Yeah, he's going to be one of the best friends that hangs around at the comic book store.
This guy, he swears he didn't write this for me, but it's an out-of-work actor who's best friends with a guy who owns a comic book store, and he's a real smart-ass alcoholic.
Yeah. I did.
I was... For some reason, in my head, I was like, okay, like, it can still be anybody. And then you said alcoholic, and I was like, that's Ryan.
Well, I don't know about alcoholic. I just added that, but...
Yeah, but it just, it works. Like, once, like, after... Because I had written, like, a version of it as a comic book. And it's violently different than what the comic book was. I just kept some of the characters because I really liked writing for them. And so when I finally wrote this pilot, and it came together, and then it's just like, oh, shit, like, this thing's getting produced. Like, holy shit, like, we're making this. And I started thinking about casting, like, right away. It's like, AJ, I'm like, let me ask Ryan. Because I feel like he would mm-hmm. you know, this is him. Like,
well,
up his alley.
I almost didn't get to do it because of stupid work.
Yeah, there's some scheduling things
well,
in the
beginning.
Well,
because you told me we weren't doing it till March.
That's what I thought. We weren't going to do it till March. And then my
producer, so I didn't ask for any time off or anything. And then he just like...
And then all of a sudden, hey!
Like, oh, man!
Yeah, like it would, the idea or the goal was to shoot it in like mid-March. And then when I was talking to my producer... She was just like, no, we're not doing that.
Yeah.
And I was just like, all right, we'll switch it up. And then, but everyone else we got casted, it's looking to be pretty funny. Like, the roles we got, they really, the auditions we've had, they've really knocked them out of the park. Like, even we had a lead, and he dropped out. And then the second guy we auditioned, I mean, he just brought it. And it's just like, man, I'm just, Isaiah.
All right.
These
nice,
are all,
nice.
All these guys
really
are working.
Excited.
Yeah. And all these guys are working for free, too.
Yeah, they're working for food.
That's awesome.
I don't have money to pay them
well,
right now.
That's still free.
Yeah, they're getting gas and crafts. That's
oh,
that's
even
what
gas.
I can afford.
That's even better.
Sure. Yeah, don't get too happy. it's 10 cents a mile, motherfucker. Like I can't afford it. So it's not money. I'll probably give you a little bit more.
Okay.
I don't want everybody to know that. But
well, you just publicly said
I know. No.
These guys don't.
That's all right.
To this.
Technically, I'm a lead, so I deserve more.
Yes. So
yeah, there you go. Yeah, by law,
you're going to be there more days than most people.
It's true.
Yeah, Isaiah is going to be there for all three, but you only need to be there for two.
Two?
Yeah, or four.
I'll talk to my agent about it.
We're shooting 4 days.
I'll talk to my lawyer about it.
And then
you're good, dude.
Lawyer rat.
And so yeah, this whole process, it's been just stressful but just enjoyable at the same time.
I'm sure once it's done, man, you're gonna be
Fucking hate pre-production. It just like it's doing the budget and then doing the shot list and trying to storyboard and then try to block and find these locations. The location's been
Well, it sounds like you've actually already done this, and as I recall, you actually wrote Tender.
Yeah, I also wrote Tender, but I wasn't
sure, but
in
he
any
wasn't
part
in any
of the production.
Yeah.
It was just
which is
script, and then, you know, they did their thing.
They threw the script out the window,
most of
it. I mean, he wrote the story.
Yeah. Story by, and scene with Evan, written by Steve Rogers.
That's right, just the one scene. He still got the writing credit, but they pretty much threw it all out the window.
But it's so we're excited about this. Like I said, I got a great crew. I couldn't ask for a better crew, honestly. Like some other people I've done projects with before, not like Tender, but like other like shorts and documentaries I've done. I've just been with shitty people, so it's just like all the work has been thrown onto me to take care of fucking everything. And now I got a team where everyone's doing exactly what they need to do.
It's great.
And it's just going so smooth.
It seems like you finally weeded out all the people that you know, because this is all. I mean. at the end of the day, it's like a class project, right?
Yeah.
So so these are all the people that were the hard workers, probably the versions of you in all different groups.
And yeah, that I never worked with.
Yeah, you finally get to work together.
Yeah, I got my team of Avengers.
Yeah, there we go.
And it's just, yeah, I'm happy with it.
Sweet.
Yeah, we already got a couple film festivals we're thinking about submitting into, like Austin TV Film Festival, a lot of things like that. And then one of the girls we work with.
Fuck yeah, man.
I'm not going to talk about that, but yeah, no. So we're, this is basically just show what I can do, show I can write, show I can direct, get a fucking job so I can start getting paid for this shit.
Yeah.
There you go.
You know.
Well, good luck to you, sir. I hope everything works out for you guys.
And by you wanting a job, you're working to get me a job.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'll give you that asshole like, all right, I got it. I'm out. Like, hey, you want to come hang out at the house? I'm not going to work with you again.
Yeah.
I'll buy you beer.
Imagine.
Oh, God. Not oh, horrible.
No, because then once you become like, we'll be like a fucking Tim Burton and Johnny Depp. Once you start making movies, I'm like, hey, bro.
I want to be in everything.
I made you. I made you.
Ben Affleck made you.
But yeah, that's the goal. That's the goal.
Well, cheers to the goal, gentlemen. I think this is a good time to wrap it up. We're kind of out of topics and everything.
I'm also drunk, so.
Yeah, so thank everybody for listening. You can. I actually opened this up and I'm like, oh, fuck. I got to drive, too.
Oh.
Oh, we got some time.
These are really fucking potent.
Little something, Lagunitas. Shout out to Lagunitas. Thank you, everybody, for listening to the podcast. Yeah, you could follow. Follow everybody on Twitter, Ryan D at
Ryan P. Demarest, teamryand.com. I'll be in San Diego next week.
There you go.
It's looking like I'm doing the show called at this place called Reds next Wednesday. I'm not sure yet, but it's looking like it's going to happen. But for sure, I'm going to be at the Comedy Palace first and second show on next Friday, which is the 24th, February 24th.
All right, there you go. And Steve, you don't have a Facebook. Well, you got Facebook.
I have Facebook. Right? I don't really use it. But if anyone wants to follow me, you can follow me on Twitter at Steve X Rogers. And yeah, I think next week I'm going to be like posting a lot of pictures and shit from set. And
nice.
I think the link for my GoFundMe will be up there too, so we can get some people paid for this fucking thing. But yeah, you can find me on Twitter.
All right. Well, thank you very much for being on the show. You can follow Rat Talk on Twitter, Rat Talk pretty much, Rat Talk everywhere. Just look it up on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. You can follow me there. To end the night, we're going to play a song that Steve showed me right now. Actually, it was, what is it again?
It's White Fang.
Yeah, White Fang. White there Fang. You go.
Bong Rip.
Bong Rip. It sounds fucking hilarious. It is hilarious. It's a good note to end on. So thank you very much for listening and tune in next week. Take another red, I'll take another.
shit, and I'm about to fucking fly off the chain, off the handle, getting down with this crazy noise.